بسم الله، الحمد لله، والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. A great you all with the greeting of Islam. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. May the peace and the blessing of Almighty Allah be with you all. I'd like to welcome you all for selected issue fiqh by Imam Al-Albani رحمة الله عليه. Today, inshallah, we're working with segment number 7. And this is point number 10, حكم أذان النساء وإقامتهن. The ruling concerning أذان, calling for the prayer for women and their إقامة for the prayer. سئل ابن عمر هل على النساء أذان فغضب وقال أنا أنهى عن ذكر الله رواه ابن أبي شيبة. The Shaykh Rahmatullah alayhi, may Allah send mercy in his soul, under this point number 10 concerning ruling for adhan and iqama in regards for women, he says that Umar, may Allah be pleased with him, been questioned concerning the adhan for women. Umar got angry for such a question and said, would you see me forbidding someone from remembering Allah? This been recorded with Al-Musannaf for Abi Shaiba and with a good narration, and Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal rahmatullah alayhi had utilized this as a argument for supporting this. The Shaykh rahmatullah alayhi say, as for the statement of Umar, for Ibn Umar, ليس على النساء أذان ولا إقامة. There is no أذان upon women, neither إقامة, or they are not obligated, or that they shouldn't, which been narrated in by Imam al-Bayhaqi رحمة الله عليه. شيخ الألباني رحمة الله عليه said ذلك أثر ضعيف وهو بظاهره مخالف لما ثبت عنه رضي الله عنه. Say this is narration is a weak narration, and this contradict what been affirmed and confirmed by Ibn Umar. Imam al-Shafi'i rahmatullah alayhi, as well Imam Ishaq, they said إذا أذن, if they call the adhan and they made iqama, there is no harm. It also been narrated that Aisha, may Allah be pleased with her, she used to call the adhan and make iqama and lead the women, and she used to stand in the middle of them. This in the collection of Imam al-Bayhaqi, and this is a strong narration as Imam al-Albani rahmatullah alayhi said. Also Umm al-Hasan, she narrated that she saw Umm Salama, wife of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, leading women in salah, stand with them in the same rank. Rawahu Ibn Abi Shayba. Sheikh Al-Albani rahmatullah alayhi commented by saying, وَهَذَا إِسْنَادٌ صَحِيحٌ. This is a authentic narration. In general, all this narration and quotation are acceptable to establish ruling about women calling the adhan and iqama for themselves, among themselves. Especially that we have the statement of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, إِنَّمَا النِّسَاءُ شَقَائِقُ الرِّجَالِ, that women are the twin of men. That means what's obligated or what's obligation upon men is obligation upon women, as long as nothing is there to prohibit them or to make it especially for men. Now, matter of clarification, not anybody to misunderstood what been said today. We are not talking about women going in minaret or getting in the media and calling the adhan for the public. This is talking about the permissibility of women calling the adhan in their own midst and in their own gathering, making iqama for themselves and also leading each other in the salah. May Allah send mercy in our Sheikh, Sheikh Al-Albani rahmatullah alayhi, and all the great scholars of Islam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the correct understanding about our deen and make us among those who preach and teach and act upon the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and became a cause to revive it back again to the pure form. Ameen. Wa akhiru da'wana an alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. سبحانك اللهم بحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك وأتوب إليك and Allah knows best.